Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make another art journal page for my mini album. I start with adding ink straight to my page and I add it like I would with a crayon, not touching all parts, making sort of stripes. Then I spray some water from the sides onto the card and I let it move a bit. And then I'm going to dry with a heat tool. I also blot the excess water. I do the same on the other two sides. And here's the base for my page with lots of texture and all different colors, all from one oxide ink. I'm going to use a Crazy Flowers and I'm going to stamp on Ultra Smooth card, and I use a Tonic Studios glue stick to add the stamp to my acrylic block. Now, I have used a regular glue stick before, and does it make a difference? Yes, it does. This glue stick is less slippery when added on the stamp, which makes the stamp stays in place right away. It's purple, but it will dry clear when you use it on your paper projects, and it's inexpensive, so that's another great thing to know. I'm going to stamp a few flowers and leaves. I'm using the color scheme from the Rubber Dance Color Challenge, and if you want to see this month's color challenge, you can check my blog. And I also added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can find the full list of supplies on my blog. The link is in the description box also. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. I cut the flowers out roughly and then I fussy cut the flowers and the leaves. I made some color charts for my Nouveau marker pens, and this way you can see all colors at one glance, and that makes it easier to pick the colors you like to use. I added a link on my blog to these color charts for you to download, so you can check that out if you like. I start with the woodland greens and I start with a light color at the top. I am no coloring expert, I just think it's fun, and the alcohol markers make it so easy to get a pretty result. I also color outside the lines, which I like for fussy cutting, so I can add a little edge around the stamp so it's not white. And when I added all colors, I go over them with a light color again to blend them together. For the flowers, I start with the oranges to color the heart, and I use the three colors again from light to dark. And I come back with the light color again to blend. For the rest of the flower, I'm going to fussy color. I have no idea if this is a term, but it's a bit like fussy cutting. I just use the broad side of the marker and start with the lightest color on the inside. I keep a piece white, like in the picture of the color challenge, and then I'm going to add the next color partly over the first, also with the broad tip, and then the same for the darkest color. Then I blend them together again with the lightest marker, and there you have a fussy colored flower. I have all parts, so on with the page. I'm going to stamp with Forest Moss again and the postcard stamp. It's a nice size to hold, so I do some random freehand stamping. I stamp and I turn the page to get the pattern in all directions. So now I have the background ready and I'm going to assemble. I first lay out all the parts and divide them on the page, and then I add them with glue and tape. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? It's available on smartphone and desktop. I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes polls and such, so you can go check that out if you like. I printed some words to finish the page and I add them with glue. So here's the finished page. I hope you are inspired to start creating yourself. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.